559 in progress. 544 in progress. Progress. Complete. 571 complete. In progress. In progress. F23 in progress. We'll be right back. 546 in progress. Four complete. F23 complete.
580. Roger. We have visual. Visual. 580. Roger. On the ground! We have visual. Roger. On the ground! We have visual. On the ground. Ground.
546 complete.
after the sixth round, if you're still telling me you didn't miss all this, I swear there'll be mushroom soup in the seventh.
I wouldn't notice the difference. Your beer is shit.
It's your beer now, First Deputy Nash. From now on, you're one of us.
Doesn't make the beer any less sour.
You're picky? That's good, it's good. The higher your position, the higher your standards. When you officially become sheriff, we'll have to make sure you got bourbon on tap.
I don't have running water.
We'll fix that, too. We'll fix everything.
Hey, Colonel, Otis asked me to give you
this. Well, finally. I thought he forgot.
Look what a mess he made of it. He could have added a little sparkle and some flowers.
I guess old Otis thought it was for Melissa. Actually, it's for my friend, the police chief.
Wow. Police chief?
I'm not the police chief.
Come on. Nobody cares about formalities. How about you, Colin? You officially the manager of the bar?
Officially, I'm unemployed. And you haven't even officially been colonel for years. So, what are we celebrating, guys? Birthday?
You could say that.
So what, Colonel? You're gonna give your friend a private dance for his birthday?
Yeah, my figure's not like it was 30 years ago.
Viola was standing for you today. She'll be free in a couple of minutes, all right?
You think I didn't try to convince them? But Mr. Nash here had a tough week. Looks like he just wants to go rest and be alone with his thoughts, I suppose.
Alone with his thoughts? Any thoughts in the police boss's head about raiding my bar?
Don't doubt this man. Our new police chief will arrest a lot of us, and your bar will be shaken from top to bottom.
And he'll find nothing but pleasure here. Okay, Colonel. Since your friend wants to be alone, maybe we'll just go up to my office and discuss the payment for our Christmas supplies.
You gonna beg me for a discount again?
Don't forget, I've got a loyal customer card.
I'll be right back, First Deputy Nash. Don't get bored.
What else does he want? All right, I'm coming already.
On your knees.
I'm not armed. I don't have a gun. I have a gun in my holster, but I'm not resisting. I'll try not
to... Lift up your head and look at me, you asshole!
Lana? It's you. Why are you... How are you here?
Shut up! As long as I'm talking, you'll be silent. You've already talked enough. You no longer have the right to a fucking word! Whatever flies out of your stinking mouth, it'll be a lie. We both know it. If you start defending yourself, you'll lie. If you start listing all those ridiculous excuses you've imagined for yourself, you'll lie. Even if you beg for forgiveness, you'll lie. All you can do now is roll around on the floor and moan pitifully. Did you hear me?
Lana, I should... I don't...
Did you hear me? Are you even capable of hearing anyone besides yourself? Oh, what a shame no one can see you now, Jack. What a shame. All those assholes reading the newspapers have you down for a criminal genius who had everyone fooled off spending his loot somewhere. And don't forget the crazies who believe you're a hero who was taken in and used. How surprised would they all be to see the real you. And here he is, the real you. An old man shitting himself with fear and nothing more. Oh, you scared, Jack? You afraid? Afraid I'm gonna arrest you, Jack? You can dream of going to prison, you piece of shit, because that's a gift you don't deserve. You won't be getting off that easy. No, 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 no. You know who is going to jail, Jack? All those bureaucrats and thieves and murderers in the expensive suits. All the con artists who seized the city and divided up all the official posts among themselves. They'll be doing serious time, I can tell you that. I swear they will go down. I know that they will go down, and they know it too. They know they're living on borrowed time. They know it's waiting for them. And when they're led out of the courthouse in handcuffs, even the most unprincipled bastard among them will know in his heart that he's got what he deserved. But not you, Jack. Because you're worse than all the rest. You think you're a victim, that it's everybody else's fault. If you go to prison, you'll think you're a great martyr. There's no punishment that you would consider fair, because after all, you're the hero who got used, right? You really believe all that. And worse, you made everyone else believe it too. Now what are we gonna do with you, Jack? What's it gonna be? What should I do now? What should your poor secretary do now? All the people who compromised their morals for you, what should we all do now? How are we going to get out of this? Do you hear the police sirens, Jack? Do you hear the helicopters? Do you hear the SWAT team breaking through your windows? You don't hear them? You know why? Because I got scared. I got scared. I ran away, and now I'm no better than you, and it's your fault. Yours and nobody else's. Look at me, Jack. Look at me, damn it! This is what you've turned me into. It's the same thing you do to everyone around you. Well, are you gonna just lie there or pour me a drink?